Rita is here. Wow. I like this. That's cool. Looks like a like she looks like all Phoenix. That's sick. I like it. Alright, let us see what Rita is all about. I don't even know where I want to start. I do want to see if she can actually fly, but we'll actually get there in a momento. So let's check out. So her dash is kind of slow, as I expected. Does she have a wave dash? I mean, she kind of does. It just looks funny. So I guess I don't even know if she can actually plink dash, but she can actually do attacks out of her dash, which is nice. But she's just not going to be a mobility powerhouse on the ground, which is fine. Which is fine. All right, let's see. Super jump. Huh. Actually, I wonder, does she have an idle animation? Let's see if she has an idle animation. It doesn't seem like she does, but who knows? They gave one to Poissandra. Okay, so probably not. She's got a lot of detail. It's actually not a bad, it's not a bad dash jump. Okay, so she's just not going to be a huge mobility powerhouse. At least in the traditional sense, which is fine. Okay, now I have to figure it out. Does she fly? How does she fly? Okay, so that's her air special. Okay. I guess you can actually do that pretty low to the ground. Okay. Okay, so that's clearly not it. Okay, well, we'll get there. Let's check out normals. Let's check out the normals. Okay. Alright. Is that good range for a jab? Let's check out comparatively. Okay. Okay. Okay, so jab isn't, like, super, anything super special. Alright. Okay. Let's check to see if this is an actual low. Okay. So an actual low. That's actually pretty good. Okay. Alright. Alright, what else we got here? So standing medium. Nothing special. Crouching medium. Okay, so part of that's a crouching medium, and I wonder if it actually does a reverse launcher? Oh, a combo screen. Interesting. That's interesting, so that combos. So, interesting. Standing heavy. Okay, so that's her launcher. So, of course, that. So that means you can actually do... Interesting. So something like that. Yeah, something like that. That's neat. Okay, cool. Okay. Okay. Alright, cool. I like it. Alright, command normal. Well, actually, air normal time. Let's see what we got here. Okay. This looks like this could set up for a tech grab, maybe? Looks like you have to delay this a lot. And then let's see how it does against crouching opponents. Okay, so... not so great against crouching opponents. Okay, actually, no. It's fine. Okay, so that was Rita's grab that I saw. So she actually did grab Jason out of the sword Rekka. I did see that right. Okay. Cool. Alright. And... oh, wow. That's active. Wow, that's active. Hitbox behind it? No, of course not. Wow. Do you see how active that is? Oh, we'll get there, though. We'll get there. We'll figure it out. Oh, this hits twice. I'm just surprised at how active this is. Like, she holds her arm out for so long, and the hitbox is active for so long. That's pretty good. Base level, that seems pretty good. Oh! Nice range. So... Okay, we're getting somewhere. We're getting somewhere. Alright, so let's go air heavy now. Oh, she has the boot. Oh, ho, ho. Okay. Alright. Okay, so a decent cross-up. I'll take it. I like it. It's command normals. Forward light.
Yeah, if you hold...
Wait, don't tell me. I want to figure it out myself. It's part of the discovery. Okay. Back medium, down medium, forward down, forward medium, back down medium, nope. Heavy, forward heavy, back heavy, down heavy. Nothing there.
I thought Squish was on.
Yeah, he was. He's back from Cali. Okay. Alright, so now let's check the move list. Okay, anti-air while airborne up. Interesting. Oh, okay. So she has a float. Interesting. I wonder. Oh, yay. She's like Storm. Mm-hmm. Oh, get ready for the oppression session. Oh. And she can do it multiple times. I wonder. Oh, you can control it. Okay, so you can control where she floats. You can time. You can see when she stops floating, and when the air current goes away, you can just press up again for her to do float more. So that's how you control her float, and you can float her more. Interesting. I'm just still like, boop. I can't wait. I can't wait for just like, boop combo. I can't wait for that. It's gonna be great. It's a good thing. I wonder. Can you? Oh. Oh, yes. Oh, the ambiguity. Oh. Oh, my goodness, the ambiguity. The ambiguity. I can't wait. I can't wait for this. It's going to be great. So, that was her only command normal. Let's see what else she's got. Okay, so that's her command normal. So, special move time? Special move time. Pinwheel Chaos. Wow. That's a lot of hits. I'm envisioning that... Wait, what's her assist? I'm curious. What's her assist?
I'm not gonna tell you. You're gonna like it, though.
Oh, she gets, darn it, what's that move... What's that move that Dormammu slash, Blackheart does? Pillar.
I call it Thunder Pillar.
I like it, Thunder Pillar. I like it. Alright, special move. Pinwheel Chaos! And she has a close one and a far one, I saw, so... Oh, whoops. Hold on. Huh. Okay. Okay. Oops. Interesting. For characters who actually have some startup on their moves, you can probably use that to catch them. Let's see if this actually does go full screen. Okay, so it doesn't go full screen. That's unfortunate. Is it a high or is it a mid? This is very important. Okay. Oh no, it's a high. That's a little unfortunate. What about this one? Okay, alright. So the close one's a mid. I like that. Wow, the block pressure. Okay, so decent projectile durability. Oh, that's good projectile durability. Because that stuff can actually go through quite a bit for some characters, so that's actually some pretty good projectile durability. Okay, forward special. Putty. Now, I saw Oh, darn it. Keep on using the wrong stuff. Putty Crusher.
Putty Go!
Okay, how did...
Get them! Putty Go!
How did she do it? I saw the putty had a hitbox behind it. It was so weird. They did it in the combo, in the thing. Does it really have a hitbox behind it? Interesting.
Prepare the path for my return! Putty Crusher!
So she can charge up the putty, I guess. If she charges it, it does something different. Okay, back special! Okay, that's interesting. So, facial tear. Does this actually have a hitbox? Okay, it does have a hitbox. Okay, so not air unblockable. I guess that'd make it too good or something like that. Okay. So it can't absorb like a whole bunch of stuff. All right, Zed. Okay, so if you press special again, she has a follow-up. Okay, all right. Ooh, cool. Oh, do I even need to? Okay, got you. So I don't even have to hit anything in order to make the Thunder Pillar come out. Interesting. Okay. And then, of course, we have this, where she goes into air animation, from which she can do any number of things. Haha! A pricing session. Not really. I don't think it's, like, that good. So, as far as I'm aware... Actually, wait, let's check out this EX. Mm-hmm. How quick can I act after this? Okay, so maybe not super fast. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Super! The dance with my people! And that looks like she can get combos after that. I don't know how. I wonder if it always puts her, like, there. Let me see if this is any different in the corner. Oh, before we actually... Whoops, that wasn't supposed to happen. Before we do that, we must answer the question, is this a command grab? Okay, not a command grab. And it looks like, based on the way Zed's blocked, it's not a low either. Yeah, not a low. Not a low, not an unblockable, so it's just a regular super. Okay, cool. Let's see if this changes at all based off of where she is on the screen. So let's go ahead and do this. Oh, okay, so it just pushes her away. So what are my options from here? Full screen? Yeah, full screen. Awesome. So, bare minimum, the fact that it is a full screen super is good. That basically means if anybody looks at you funny and you have 2 meters, you can just suck them into Hiffle and do the dance of your people for like half life. So, that's not bad. All right, let's see if there is... Oh, hold on. There we go. Let's see if there is anything else. So, anti-air, the float, pinwheel chaos near far, chaos spark, royal candle. Oh, so you can control where this goes. Okay, hold on. So, closed. Oh, okay. Okay, and then... You know what this reminds me of? In a weird way, this actually reminds me of Geese. Geese's double Repukin. It's what it reminds me of. You use the first Repukin in order to, like, soak projectiles, and then you use the follow-up, his other Repukin, as kind of like a way to kind of take back your turn in, like, a zoning war. Granted, this isn't full screen. Actually, I wonder how projectile durable this is, because, I mean, assuming this is a projectile... You could probably use this to absorb multiple projectiles as well. Let's check this out. All right. Okay. Okay, not bad. Interesting. Okay. So Royal Candle, so she can do that mid, near, or far. Putty, Putty Crusher, Wicked Circuit, Repulsa Blast. That's hilarious. Repulsor Blast, Repulsa Blast. Finsters. Finster! Okay, and then we got forward throw, back throw. So we already did forward throw, back throw. The only thing I'm not really seeing is like an easy way to combo from some of her things that make her go farther away. Offhand, what I'm thinking is like some combination of this. Oh, not bad. Some combination of doing this. And then some combination of doing like this for follow-ups. That's where I see like a lot of her extensions that push people to full screen going. Let me try this actually. Yeah, that's what I see, but that's not a full screener, so that makes that really interesting. Okay. Now, I will say this, Rita is definitely not flowing nearly as easily as Poissandra as far as like just figuring out stuff that kind of works together. Like with Poissandra, her extensions, if you have played this game like even like a little bit, the way that she extends combos and whatnot seems to make a lot more sense than what Rita does. And Rita is gonna be a more complex zony character with just her ability to manipulate where she throws like her orb, where she projects like her spatial tear and her thunder pillar. She's a very interesting character. A lot more complex than I was expecting. I definitely don't think Rita's gonna be easy. Base moveset level, I think she actually might be more difficult than Adam. Like, I'm not talking about Ninjetti mode, but just base level what Rita does, just her base toolkit. She seems like probably the more difficult of the three characters. But I feel like similar to Zed, in her own way, she'll be one of those more execution-heavy characters. But if you can put the time into her, I definitely think that she'll have a really high potential ceiling. But only time will tell, I suppose. But yeah, I guess that's my base assessment of Rita. I wish I could really think of like some neat combos to do with her. Normals aren't fantastic, but normals aren't particularly bad either. Like, all of our normals hit from roughly about, like, here-ish. Anything beyond that, so, I mean, yeah, normals are okay. Air normals are pretty good. Air normals are pretty good. All of her air normals are pretty good, which kind of reinforces the aerial nature. Mobility, not great. Similar to Zed. I don't know, maybe you're a plink dasher, maybe your mobility will be better, but like similar to Zed, mobility is not fantastic, but one thing she does have over Zed is the fact that she can actually do attacks out of her dash, unlike Zed. Yeah, zoning tools are good, but not straightforward. She's not gonna be like a brain dead zoner. She isn't gonna be as easy to use as like Macedon Sentry or like Ranger Slayer. There's a lot more active thinking that you have to do with Rita. But I think her skill ceiling or her potential ceiling will be much higher, though, as well. So, yeah, that is interesting. All right, I'll have to figure out how to do combos on my own time. Let's go ahead and fire up a lobby, and then after I do that, I'm going to be reacting to the patch notes because I'm really excited to see finally what on paper changes they're going to be doing for. I mean, maybe not everybody, but you know what I mean.